Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and get regular updates from AE.
Hey folks, welcome to AE. Rishabh here, and yes, right beside me is the Hyundai's tall boy. Almost more than two decades ago, with Shah Rukh Khan, we launched this new car that was, of course, the Hyundai Santro. A very new car, like, of course, it was not a sedan, it was not a very small hatchback, it was something in between. It was a car with a lot of headroom and a very practical car. So the 23rd of October 2018 is the day which Hyundai came out with the all new Santro, not a facelift, a complete generation gap. So in this video, of course, we are going to have a look at the all new Hyundai Santro. Before I start with the actual video, it would be a great pleasure if you guys could hit the subscribe button after watching the complete video. So yes, today we are going to have a look at the top 6 reasons to buy the Hyundai Santro. So here is the tall boy from Hyundai after 4 odd years of manufacturing. Talking about the exteriors first, the design of the car is what is completely new, but for some eyes it might resemble as the already well known Grand i10. Front is an absolutely new affair in the all new Santro, with halogen bulb headlights that are bulging and round, with the already known cascade grille design to give it a new look accompanied with fog lamps. Come to the side of the car to witness the small yet cute tallboy design with 14 inch wheels with wheel hub. The side is also highlighted with sharp character lines near the front fender and the quarter panel. Side view mirrors get stern indicators as well. The rear of this car is also, which looks completely new without any details taken from any other car. The taillight as first are completely new with dual tone body color bumper. Talking about the dimensions, this tall boy from Hyundai is measured at a length of 3610mm, 1645mm in width, and stands tall at 1560mm with a ground clearance of 170mm. Also offering a boot of 235L with rear seat bench folding facility. The all new Santro offers more room for the entire family with a black and beige interior and unique elephant inspired center fascia. The interior features semi-fabric seats which looks plush and comfortable. The dash also accommodates AC vents with champagne gold accents and a glove box of a decent size. The center fascia, as said before, is unique in design and also features a 7-inch entertainment system and an amazing air conditioning system with dials and knobs. The multifunctional steering wheel helps you control the media department without actually leaving the steering wheel, whereas the small 6.35cm advanced cluster with MID helps the driver get all the information on the go. The placement of the window controls is placed in the center with a couple of cup holders, whereas the passengers in the rear are complemented as well with a huge cabin space and door bins. Now talking about the feature list, the all new Santro gets a 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Apple CarPlay, Android Auto and Mirror Link, whereas the same screen can be used for reverse parking camera and smartphone connectivity. In extras, you do get a USB port and a 12-volt socket in the front as well. The multifunctional steering wheel in here gives navigation buttons, volume controls and voice command button, also featuring eco coating technology in the aircon system. The rear passengers get AC vents, which is the first in segment feature, whereas in extras you get rear parking camera and rear parking sensors. Safety front here is taken care by dual airbags and ABS with EBD, which is standard across all the variants, and in extras you get impact sensing door unlock feature and also an fire extinguisher if you opt for the company fitted CNG Santro. Yes, you heard it right, this time you get an option of CNG fuel alternative from the company itself. Mated to a 1.1-litre 4-cylinder engine pumping out 59 PS of power and 84 Nm of torque is the CNG unit. Now also you get an option of a 1.1-litre petrol unit churning out 69 PS of power and 99 Nm of torque, all mated to a 5-speed gearbox, or you can opt for a smart auto AMT only available in the petrol variant. Finally, giving a mileage of 30 km per litre and 20 km per litre respectively, launched in India after 4 years of rest, Santro is available at a price of 3.9 to 5.65 lakhs ex-showroom Delhi. So those were a couple of things about the exteriors, the interiors, the specifications, features, power and whatnot. So I hope you guys liked the video till now, and if you have liked it, please do subscribe you know, please, please do subscribe. And now we start with the real deal. Like, how is the car? Like, genuinely starting from the power delivery, the suspension setup, the gearbox, you know, the sync between the gearbox and also the engine. So right now I'm driving the 1.1 liter petrol that produces 69 PS of power. And to be really very frank, this car weighs somewhere around, you know, more than 850-900 kgs, which depends on the model, of course, like Astra, Magna. We have different cars with different weight ratios. So now let's start from the first thing, that is, of course, how the power delivery is coping up with the car. Like, a 1.1 liter engine doesn't really give that much of power, but yes, 69 PS is, I think, enough, because this is a city car and you won't have to take it to long journeys. Like, you will take it, but not that not that frequently. So this 1.1 liter petrol will give you an adequate power of, let's say, you know, it'll reach till a top speed of 110 or 115. Again, just with my experience, like, I won't take it on a very high speed. Now talking about the power delivery, as in, you know, in the first couple of gears you will get a decent amount of power, and of course the top speed won't be like in the last couple of gears. You won't get that very quick pickup kind of a feel. So yeah, that is about the 1.1 liter petrol. I can't really say much about the 1.1 CNG because really we don't have that, you know, car available to, you know, roam around or to at least to drive. Now talking about the suspension setup, I am on a very bumpy road right now, and which really can say that it has a bit on a harder side. Like, the suspension setup is on a bit of a harder side, so that can be compromised, or I would say, as a user, I kind of like the hard suspension setup, because of course it gives you a feel like you are not on a boat of some sort. So that is the suspension deal. Now talking about the gear setup, we have a 5-speed manual gearbox and also the AMT. It's not completely automatic, neither CVT. So it's automated manual transmission. And again, I haven't driven that. But yes, Hyundai's are well known for the Verna's automatic. Again, they don't have any AMT in that one. So really, you know, we can't say a lot about that car in general. Now talking about the things which is left, that is, of course, the braking system. It would cope up with the car because, of course, it's a lighter car. Like, you know, 850-900 kgs is not that much, but still you will get a decent amount of braking, you know, power, because right now I am driving with two persons, like including me. So this is not completely empty, this is not completely full. So it's giving me a decent braking power. So that's it about the first impression. Like, how do I feel? Like, for city roads is the best car, again, because of the in-cabin space and the tall boy look. It gives you a great headroom and, you know, leg room in the entire car, even if you talk about the passenger sitting in the rear seat. So yeah, that's it about the car, and these were my first impressions. If you have any doubts, please do comment them down in the comment section below. And as always, this is Rishabh signing off. Please don't forget to subscribe if you liked watching this video. I've been trying to, you know, make my videos look good and explain the things about the car in a better manner. So yes, thanks for watching this video. This is Rishabh signing off. Thank you. I just like the sound.